Hello everyone, in this video we'll see how to create this cripple artifact that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Okay, so let's go and open Photoshop and let's go to File, New, and let's put around 3000 pixels for the width, and I think I will put 4000 in the height. I will keep the resolution set to 72, RGB in color mode, and I will press OK. Alright, now this is basically a fairly easy effect to do if you have the right brushes. And by the way, we're gonna actually use custom preset brushes, which is basically just like some pictures that I took from my phone. I will show you like this. I just took some papers and I start drawing like that, like scribble some lines like that, and then I cut them in Photoshop and I change them or I transform them to brushes, and then I add some presets on them so they will work very good for this. You will find all these brushes in the link from the description below to download for free, and all this because of the Patreon family that make this possible. Alright, so now the first thing that I want to do is actually create a background, so I'm just gonna go to adjustments and choose solid color, and let's actually use like 15 brightness for now. And this is like where you can choose the brightness of the color, so I will choose 15 between white and black, and that will be okay. Alright, now we'll just delete this background and let's call this BG for background. Alright, next I will create a new layer and then I will call it image. Now this is optional, you can do this or no, you can just drag an image that you want to use. But for me, I want to change it to Smart Object, and then I will open it by going to Edit Content, and I will drag my image that I want to use, which is this one. I will open it in here, and this this effect, I think it works best if you have like a close-up image. I mean, it works best for all kind of images, but for me I prefer it to be like this in a close-up portrait like that. Alright, so I would keep it like this and I will close this. I will make sure to press yes to save. Alright, next I will apply some adjustments. I will go to image and I will choose shadows and highlights. Now this image it already have a lot of exposure, so but I want to bring out the shadows a little bit more. The highlights we don't need because they are already here, so we don't need them to be that much, maybe just a little bit. And for the shadows I will put them on like 15 or 16% like that. Alright, next I will go back to filter and I will choose filter gallery, and in the brush stroke you can use whatever stroke or whatever brushes that will work best for you. For me, I just want to add a little bit of like a painting feel to this, so I will go with the cross hatching here, and you can play with these numbers in here. It's you need to experiment with them, but for me I think I would keep it like this and I'll press OK. All right now let me just edit this layer mask in here. Alright, now I'm gonna actually create a layer mask, and I need to transform or I need to invert this layer mask to black because now we have it white. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command I while I'm selecting the layer mask. I will press Ctrl Command I, and the other way to do it, you can open the properties and in here you can find invert, and this will invert the layer mask, and now we will see the background that we created. Alright. Now this is fairly easy to do, we're just gonna use the brushes that you will find down in the description below. As you can see in here you will find 8 brushes, and you can just switch between them to create your art. But before we're gonna do that, as you can see, I can't see anything where to start. So there is a trick that I always like to use, is actually I double click on this layer mask to open the properties, and then I'm gonna put the density to like 95% to see where the feature of the face is. Now I can easily start painting using my brush, using white as my foreground color because I have black layer mask. I can go ahead and start, like, you know, just following the feature that I want to be visible. We'll start with the eye in here, and then a little bit in this eye too. And I will switch to another brush, maybe this one. And that's the trick, you keep switching between the brushes, and it will create really nice scribble art for you. And I will go and switch to this brush for now. And again, I will follow where the face is. And I'm switching between Ctrl Command Z to go back and forward. If I see something that I don't like, I switch between Ctrl or Command Z to go back. Let's go to another brush. I mean, the nice thing about these brushes is that they are created using a hand created, so they have a really nice texture in them, and that actually make a big difference. So let's go and choose another one, maybe this one. Go in here, maybe I will focus more about the eye and a little bit of the nose. All right, something like that. And now I can go ahead and make the density back to 100. And as you can see, we already start to get a really nice art of the eyes and the mouth and the nose. A lot of people, they will like it like this, but for me, I think I want to add a little bit more to the image. Maybe I will go with another brush, maybe this one, just to add a little bit more character to the whole thing. Yeah, something like that. Maybe a little bit in this area. As you can see, the whole trick with the brush, if you have a nice brush, you will get really nice results. Something like that. Maybe in here too. And a little bit in this area. Another thing that you can use is to click R on your keyboard, and this will allow you to rotate the canvas itself, and this actually helps a lot when it comes to the angle of the artwork that you are creating. As you can see, now I can follow this part of the nose, maybe with another brush, this one. Want to be in this part in here from the mouth and a little bit in this area. All right, so I would keep it like this for now. Maybe I can go back and edit this more, but I think it looks really interesting like this. And let's see what to add for it to be more interesting. All right, as you can see now, you can easily change the background or the color of the background if you want. Maybe you can put it red, a little bit like this, maybe a little bit of color, bluish, or maybe a little bit of red, or maybe brownish color. You get the idea. You can even change it to white if you want. For me, I like it in these dark tones in here. Yeah, something like this one. I think it looks really interesting. All right, so I'll keep it like that. Now it's up to you. You can actually change this to black and white, but I will show you just in case if you want to do that, you can. You can just go to adjustment and choose hue and saturation and clip it to the image itself by one click on this icon. And you can just drop down the opacity. And as you can see, it will look also interesting, black and white. But for me, I think I will keep it like that because I like the colors. And the other thing that I want to add is some textures that I already have in here. I will make sure to upload this one for you guys too. So I will open them, I'll open this one, and I will make it fit with the canvas, something like that. All right, And I will change the blending mode of this to soft light, and I will drop down the opacity quite a bit, maybe 25%. All right. Then I will open the other texture that I have in here, and I will make it bigger again. And for this one, I will change the blending mode to multiply, and I will drop down the opacity to like 50%. As you can see, it will give it a really nice character to the whole thing. And again, you can go back and change the blending, the color of the background to whatever you prefer. For me, I think with a dark gray color, it will look very interesting like that. Alright, I think I like this. Now, let's actually group these textures. And let's call this texture. And then I'm gonna apply an adjustment. So I will go to adjustments and choose levels. And I will choose from the default presets. I will go for like increased contrast number 2. And as you can see, the difference it makes with the contrast decrease in here. And I will put it down a little bit to like 60%. And the last thing I want to add is a color lookup. So I will go and open color lookup in here. And let's go for something a little bit warm, maybe like futuristic bleak in here, to have this really nice bluish color in here. But I think it's a little bit strong, so I will put down the opacity to like 40% or 50%. Just to add a little bit of that warmth color. You know what, let's change it to color dodge and see. It will bring more of the colors like that. Yeah, I think it looks really interesting like this. And let's group everything and let's call this adjustment. All right, so that will be our effect. As you can see, this is before and this is after. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know wait for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.